Hello everyone again, this is sbiggs and CQR Shifty giving another TORA track guide around Suzuka circuit. How are you, Shifty?
I'm fine, thank you. Hope everyone else is well.
Fantastic. So this is going to be quite an interesting circuit, isn't it, really, because there's a lot of twists and turns. And would you say this is more of a downforce circuit?
Most definitely, especially with the S's right at the beginning of the lap, a lot of flowing corners leading from one to another. You really do need a lot of downforce and a well-balanced car.
So let's make our way down to turn one, which obviously there's going to be a braking point involved in that. Where would you say would be somewhere good to look out for?
There are not so many reference points with braking markers as such. A good reference to you'd probably be the lamppost actually on the side of the circuit, or actually the pit exit line as well. That would also be a good reference. A few shadows on the map. You want to be braking quite early, so you obviously there's a big roll trap on the exit. So you really, really very important turn on the circuit to get right, especially as it leads onto another corner that is right ahead of you.
There's a lot of runoff here on the left-hand side of the track. Is it ideal to use that or to stay away from it?
I'd get as close to it as possible, but I preferably wouldn't use it. It could unsettle the car and send you off, especially if you lock a brake, just send you off straight into the gravel and you lose a lot of time.
For me, I reckon this particular corner's got quite a lot of grip behind it, so it's quite nice to keep a good line around there.
Yeah, it's also cambered as well, which helps the car. You can take more speed through it there.
Coming up to the S's now, and something that I've heard for these particular corners is that's key to these corners is what gear that you're in.
You really want to be hitting the peak power band, getting the most out of the engine, but also so that you don't understeer off the circuit. Really, it's really important to get a nice rhythm going into the S's. You want to try and stay off the curves as much as you can. Swing out to the middle of the track. You want to go far right. You can use a bit of the curb here. There's a tiny bit of runoff on the inside as well.
This one, you need to slow down for a bit, would you not?
Yeah, you need to slow down a bit. Maybe just lift off the power for a few seconds, if that. You really need to keep the speed as reasonable as possible, so you don't compromise your entry for this long uphill left-hander.
And where would you say would be a good clipping point for this one? Because it's quite hard to judge for here.
Probably want to look for the middle of the curb, which will then send you out towards where the shorter course is. You want to be running around here on the exit and trying to carry as much speed through as possible, and you'll slowly start moving over to the left hand side following the racing line before all the deadness.
Okay, question, Shifty. Do you brake for Degna 1?
Yes, in a GT car I would.
Would it just be a quick dab on the brakes, or would you...
It would be a dab on the brakes, down a gear.
Okay.
You really want to be aiming. Can use as much of that as possible while respecting the track limits and not dirtying your lap. And you want to use as much of this as well, also within keeping the track limits. You gain a few miles an hour coming off that using that, then you want to get hard on the brakes for the second Degna, and can use that inside curb to turn the car a tiny bit more. You have got the runoff on the left hand side, which you can use. Obviously it goes to grass under the bridge. You want to be sticking to the left hand side of the circuit for a very, very key overtaking opportunity.
Degna 2, the green section just beyond the normal rumble strip, that's good to use, isn't it? Obviously within keeping two tyres on the track.
Exactly.
Maybe just having your right tyres just sort of touching it. So, very heavy braking point and possibly a very good overtaking opportunity here.
Yes, there are multiple lines you can take into this Eppin. You obviously want to be on the left-hand side, coming over to the right if you're on a qualifying lap. If in a race situation, you could be side by side, and be giving each other as much room as you possibly can, and then hard on the brakes, and just trying to clip the apex right in the middle, before swinging out towards the exit curb. Try not to use much of it, and then hard on the power for a long sweeping straight.
Breaking point for the hairpin. This is, I'm gonna look over the edge. Where would you say would be a good breaking point for the hairpin?
You want to come round the right hander, and then just as you start to straighten the car up, you want to jump on the brake as hard as you can.
Cool. Right, we're now coming up to what they call spoon curve. I'm guessing that's because it's in the rough shape of a spoon, although looking at the track map on the bottom left, I can't really see it. What would be, I think the actual right hander here, again, is going to be key to getting the two left-handers right, is it not?
Yeah, you want to be carrying a lot of speed, but you also really need to get the line perfect. If you can line up this quite fast right-hander, you'll be doing 130-140 mile an hour as you reach this point, maybe even faster. You really need to, you can't touch the curb, it'll just unsettle the car before you get to the braking zone, so you really need to be nice and smooth through this corner.
And then once you've come out of this right hand turn, you're going to be wanting to sort of keep it on the right hand side.
Yes, you want to be keeping it on the right hand side so you can go as much speed through the first part of the spoon curve as you possibly can.
Breaking point I tend to use for this is where the you've got a small bit of tarmac on the right hand side of the circuit, and I found that's a really good sort of reference point.
Yeah, that is also my reference point. It's very, very useful. You're only braking just as you reach the tarmac and trying to get it turned in as early, well, not as early as possible, but just in time so you clip the apex three quarters of the way through the curb. Swing out wide, there is runoff here, obviously respect the track limits, and then obviously the second part of this spoon curve is much more difficult than the first. The car's twitching all over the place, you really, really need a well-balanced car to make the most of this corner before another key straight, so getting the apex perfect can really make or break your lap.
Clipping the apex on the second part of the spoon curve, is that worth attacking, or does that upset the car too much?
It's worth attacking, but don't use too much of the curve, it will unsettle the car.
How'd you do this part of the circuit, Shifty?
Well,
put the accelerator down, done.
Yeah, exactly. Floor it. Shake and bake.
Right, coming up to spoon curve now. And again, is there going to be a braking point for this particular track? I suppose it depends on what your tuning is.
Yeah, it really depends how your car's set up. If you've got a very high downforce car, it could possibly be flat. I'm not brave enough to try it, but some of the more quick drivers, well, they may try it. Just to be on the safe side, I would. A tiny dab on the brake, depending on your gearing, either knock it down one gear or leave it in the same gear. But again, this is an iconic corner in motorsport, 130 arm in. It's just incredible.
So, coming up to the final chicane now, again, there'd be the question of a braking point. So what would we be looking out for?
Well, there is a part of the circuit where the tyre tracks, or the actual racing line, it does get considerably darker. There's also a good reference. There's also the bridge is a bit too late. You want to be braking just before that. Maybe the end of the tyre barrier on the right hand side is a good place to brake. Obviously, it has been a scene of controversy over the years. Hopefully, we try to keep it nice and clean.
I have also just noticed as well, on the right-hand side of us, there's a speed down sign, which obviously might be quite a good indicator.
Yes, it might. You might want to do that. I don't think you'd like to approach this final turn without braking.
And then the line through the actual turns, I tend to attack the curbs as much as possible, remaining within obviously track limits.
Yes, attacking the curb, it can find you a lot of time, obviously, within respecting the track limits. There is a lot of time to be found here by attacking these curbs. So you don't want to overdo it, because it will unsettle the car, especially on the exit before the start finish straight.
That completes episode 3 of the TORA Track Maps. Thank you for joining us, and we'll see you again next time.